Cryptocurrency crash. Is it time to buy or sell your cryptocurrency now? Hello everyone, my name is Wagner. Now we need to take a look at the crypto market today because it has been selling off for the past several weeks and especially this past weekend. And I knew that I needed to make a video on this today as a lot of people are getting very fearful and panic selling. So in this video, we are going to take a look and see if it's time to buy or sell your cryptocurrency. And we're also going to take a look at what smart money is doing right now. But before we get started, it would mean a lot to me if you guys hit that like button and subscribe to the channel if you haven't done so already. It really does help out the channel a lot. So let's get into it. So we have Bitcoin down 16% within the last week, currently below and dropping to $32,000, and Ethereum down 21% in the past week, roughly around that $2,000 mark. Overall, we are seeing a nice sell-off happening over the past week, and nearly $200 billion was wiped off from the cryptocurrency market, adding to the $200 billion that was already lost over the past 7 days. And one of those reasons of why I think people are worried right now is that there is a ton of investors concerned about the impending death cross, which may signal a transition from a bullish to a bearish price trend. But if we zoom out on the chart, we can see that Bitcoin is still up over 13% year to date and over 30,000% since it was first launched. Now, for those of you that don't know, a death cross occurs when the 50-day moving average crosses below the 200-day moving average. But even despite all of this, a lot of analysts still continue to be bullish on Bitcoin, including myself. But I know that right now there's a lot of FUD, fear, uncertainty, and doubt. And all of that has come from regulatory uncertainties and environmental concerns that weigh heavily on Bitcoin. Now, China's biggest crypto mining centers got an inspection notice on Thursday that forced them to stop mining operations. And on Friday, Wu Blockchain revealed that Alibaba Cloud, China's largest cloud service provider, contacted cryptocurrency and mining firms registering in China about the possibility of domain name cancellation due to legal restrictions. Now, the Chinese government is cracking down on Bitcoin mining, and concerns that China would continue to crack down on Bitcoin mining have actually helped the overall FUD. Now, according to Global Times, the current restriction implies that more than 90% of China's Bitcoin mining power, which accounts for about 75% of global capacity, is expected to go offline. And in the long run, this might actually be beneficial to Bitcoin, given that the bulk of Bitcoin mining in China used non-renewable energy sources like coal. Now, miners are expected to relocate to nations and regions that promote sustainable energy. And we have known for a little while now that Miami, Florida, wants to be the Bitcoin center of the world and has been trying to attract China Bitcoin miners to the city. Not only that, but we have some big money buying and institutions showing a lot of demand for cryptocurrency. Now, despite all of the legal roadblocks, institutional demand for cryptocurrency remains incredibly high, potentially forcing nations to compete for crypto-related companies. For example, we have Spanish banking firm BBVA saying on Friday that its cryptocurrency trading and custody service will be offered to private banking clients in Switzerland starting June 21st. Also, we have Crypto.com, a cryptocurrency trading software, setting a target of being carbon negative in the next 18 months. One River Digital, a financial services business, has also applied for a carbon neutral Bitcoin exchange traded fund, an ETF. CoinShares, a digital asset investment business, made a strategic investment in Verity Funds and promised to help management on the first ESG crypto mining product in the United States. We also have Wrapped, a partnership between tokenization specialist TokenSoft and digital asset custodian Anchorage, announcing the launch of EcoBTC, a carbon neutral Bitcoin backed asset. And we also have big companies taking advantage of this current dip, one of them being MicroStrategy. Now, MicroStrategy currently owns a little over 100,000 Bitcoins. They actually announced today, Monday, that it now owns more than 100,000 Bitcoins after spending $489 million for 13,500 coins in a new buy round. Now, currently, the average purchase price of MicroStrategy is around 26,000 $1 per coin, including fees and other expenses, according to the company. Currently, the company's holdings are valued at more than $3 billion. MicroStrategy has gone from not so much of a well-known company to a really well-known company in Wall Street and also the crypto community within the past year, owning an aggressive amount of Bitcoin and investing aggressively within the past few months. Now, CEO Michael Saylor, who often promotes Bitcoin on Twitter, has been very bullish on Bitcoin very recently. Now, we also have Grayscale Investments authorizing Digital Currency Group to acquire up to $50 million worth of Grayscale Ethereum Classic Trust shares, and they are intending to fund the purchase with cash on hand. Now, the share purchase authorization does not commit DCG to buy a certain number of shares over a specific period of time, and it can be increased, extended, amended, or terminated at any time. Now, the exact timing, quantity, and value stock purchase will be determined by a variety of factors. So we clearly have a lot of institutional demand, and cryptocurrency promises to be able to solve a bigger issue. Not only that, but we also have some really big catalysts coming in the next few weeks, and one of them being the Ethereum upgrade coming in July, so only a few weeks away, and it's going to make Ethereum faster, and it's going to allow for more users to use the Ethereum applications. Now, another catalyst that we need to look forward to is the launch of smart contracts on the Cardano blockchain, which I believe is going to bring the price even higher. Now, the smart contracts are scheduled to launch in August on Cardano, and there's currently about 100 projects that have shown support for launching their application on Cardano when they go live. Now, the main catalyst here is going to be with Bitcoin, as we have more Bitcoin ETFs in the works, and there's going to be an even more adoption of Bitcoin in more Latin American countries, as we have already seen with El Salvador accepting Bitcoin as legal tender. And we have also seen support from Mexico, Paraguay, and Brazil, and I'm sure it's only a matter of time before they make some serious moves. So if you're still wondering what we should do during these crypto drops, as I know that they can be really scary, well, the crypto is very volatile and are more common than you think. All markets fall at some point, whether it's the housing market or the stock market. So if you have no cash left to buy the dip, then it's sometimes better to just keep your cool and do absolutely nothing. In the crypto market, volatility are so common, and you'll be more likely to receive a return of your investment over time if you make an investment on a good cryptocurrency with good fundamentals and just ride the market. And just remember that we want to buy low and eventually sell high. We do not want to buy when it's green or buy when it's high and sell low or sell when it's red. It's super straightforward. And of course, if the market falls, so as the saying goes, if the price of a potential cryptocurrency has dropped during a crash, then that might be the best time to invest and have true diamond hands. This is especially true if the price of a cryptocurrency you've been watching has dropped a significant amount. So the number one thing to do here is to just remain calm. And I'm saying this because there has been a lot of panic in my comment section, as making emotional judgments, especially when investing, will cause you to stay away from any positive return investment. So before you get into the cryptocurrency market, just remember why you're investing in a specific cryptocurrency in the first place. And are you actually invested because you believe in the long-term potential of blockchain? Are you just in it to make a short-term profit? So you need to become more aware of what it is that you're trying to achieve and build enough conviction on your investment. And to put it simply, if you believe in the long-term potential of the cryptocurrency or just blockchain overall, then you should think of it like that and see red days in the market as the perfect time to go shopping. And if you're here to make money overnight, then it more than likely won't happen. So you need to go into this market, especially the crypto market, knowing that you could lose it all overnight. So I actually see this time as another great buying opportunity, as some of the coins that I have the strongest conviction in have dropped significantly. And if you bought at the top, then average down. And if you have no more money to invest, then just hold, set it, and forget it. And if this is your first time investing, then one of the things that I would recommend is just dollar cost average, meaning investing little by little over time, no matter what the market is doing. If the market's low, you invest a little more. If the market's high, you invest a little more. Because as always, time in the market beats timing the market. And if you're interested in learning more about the different types of cryptocurrencies, I made a video on my top 5 cryptocurrencies for 2021 that I would recommend you watch. The majority of the research is already done for you, but you should always make sure to do your own due diligence. So with that in mind, if you enjoyed this video, then be sure to give this one a thumbs up, subscribe, share it, and check out the links down below to grab your 4 free stocks from Webull, your 3 free stocks from Robinhood, and up to $500 worth of cryptocurrency using my links below. Again, thank you guys so much for watching. Until next time.